Suomen vuori, kaunis on Suomi. Hi, this is Mark Wiltshire. Thanks for joining this bonus episode of the Finnish Football Show. And I'm really delighted today to be joined by Niila Arajuuri. Hi, Niila.
Hi, Mark. Thank you so much for having me.
We're going to talk about your song for the hookah for Euro 2020. But first of all, I'm looking behind you. It's a beautiful day and you're in Cyprus. What are you doing in Cyprus?
Yeah, Paulus, my brother, he had some kind of job duties to do. So as it happens, he went for the Euros for the summer, and he had the idea. He called me and my girlfriend. We live in Berlin, and he was like, "How would you guys feel about spending a summer in Cyprus, like looking over the house?" And yeah, obviously we didn't have to discuss that for many minutes. Like, of course, right away we were on the next plane basically now. But it's absolutely amazing. It's such a beautiful sunny place, and there's two very happy plant waterers here at the moment.
It sounds like the best summer job ever.
Yeah, really. Oh man, perfect. No complaints.
I thought we'd talk obviously about the song Sukupolvien Unelma, but also a little bit about you and your connection with football as well. So maybe let's start there. I found a few quotes and a few comments online, and I thought I'd use those and then ask some questions around that. And I found a comment that said, as a child, Niila desperately wanted to become a professional footballer. So when did you first get into football?
I think we both started with Paulus. I'm a year older, so I think we were actually 5 and 4. So I think that was the first time my dad took us to practice, and you know, then back then basically it's just the whole team running after the ball, and that doesn't have that much to do with football. It was just so much fun. But yeah, that's when it started. Then we always played in the same teams. Paulus also played with his own age group, and then also with the older boys, and I've always loved football. But actually, that quote, I think you might have found it on Universal Music. Is it like there's like a bio?
It might have been on the website. Yeah,
on exactly. The website. Yeah. And it is actually the interviewer who wrote the biography, like. He colored it a little bit, and I was gonna change it in the end, but he is like, this is a nice story. So it actually is football for me. I always loved it so much, but I never had that dream or passion for football as much, or actually like practicing so much. I fell in love with music around high school, and that really just like a brick, like hit me in the head like a brick, and then never looked back since. But football has still always been a big part of obviously our family and our life, and absolutely love it, and that's why it's just so such a blessing to be able to follow Paulus's games and career. So much fun.
Your grandfather Urjo played for the national team as well.
Yeah.
Wow.
He was actually a goalkeeper. Yeah.
And they weren't known as the hooker yet back then. I don't know what nickname the Finnish national team had when he was playing for the team.
Yeah, not sure. I would have checked that up. Yeah.
So what team do you follow?
I think I must be one of the guys who changes the club most frequently in the world, basically, because I always follow the team where Paulus is playing. So
okay, because this is quite a modern phenomenon that I've become aware of, that kind of kids now, they follow a player. So there are Messi fans or Ronaldo fans. You were just ahead of the curve. You're a Paulus fan.
Yeah, and I think it's because we grew up in small town Halkia and then Nummela, and which didn't have we weren't that close to any big club necessarily in Finland, and I think, yeah, it's just I never had like a huge club that I was following. So then it's always been where Paulus is playing, of course, rooting for that team with all my heart, and then on to the next team.
Okay, now the Finnish football show is a broad church. I'm in Seinäjoki, so I follow SJK and Rich. It's kind of connected to where our wives and girlfriends are from. So Rich is a Kups fan. Keke is a JJK fan, and I think Mark has a soft spot for HJK, and of course then we all kind of come together around the hockey.
Yeah,
nice. I'm going to read you another quote that came from that same piece. So let's see if this is coloured as well. But it said that your story as a musician, you just said that you got into music as a teenager and never looked back. And it said that you were inspired by your dad's record collection.
Yeah.
Tell me a little bit about that.
Yeah, our dad is definitely a music lover at heart, and he was in his younger years. He was a drummer in a band, and he also wrote beautiful songs. I actually definitely stole a few of his melodies to my tracks. But we always had instruments around the house. We had a piano, and I actually had a drum set, my dad's drum set in my room all the way since like elementary school to high school, and obviously that was a big hit around the neighborhood kids, so like all the kids from the neighborhood were banging the drums from morning till night, so thank you for the parents and sorry for the neighbors.
Well, I think the parents were probably just happy that the kids were banging the drums in your house and not in their own house.
Yeah, right, exactly. But and dad, he has a huge record collection, vinyls and CDs, and there was always music playing around the house. And that's always like childhood memories is always connected with music.
Yeah, I think we all pick up certain artists or bands or whatever from our parents.
Absolutely.
And in my house, it was more from my mum. My dad didn't listen to so much music. I remember more him listening to sort of talk radio type content. Mm. And that now continues that he listens to podcasts, and I've got him into listening to podcasts, and we kind of exchange shows to listen to. Yeah. But from my mum, I can definitely remember getting my love of the Carpenters and Frankie Valli and the Four Seasons directly from my mum. When I hear those songs, it takes me back to being a kid. What bands were like that for you?
There were many, but I think bands like Toto and Sting and the Police, Stevie Wonder, and I think it had the music around the house had a big impact that I actually started writing music from the beginning in English, even though being Finnish and living in Finland, and I have like the football song, obviously there was only one language, the right language to do it with, and it was such a fun experience to write in Finnish, and I absolutely want to do music also in Finnish one day, but for some reason I think it has a big impact, the music around the house has a big impact why I started from the beginning, writing music in English.
Somehow just felt more natural when you started writing.
Yeah, it is. It's funny, isn't it? Even though it's not your native language, but somehow when most of the music you listen to at that time is in English, then it somehow became more natural. Or I don't know what it is. It's I've thought about it many times, but like I said, it was so much fun to do the Hukka song in Finnish, and I can't wait to write more.
Did it feel different somehow writing in Finnish? Did it need a different sort of process?
Somehow I don't think any song ever happened as easily. Sometimes lyrics is the part where I might struggle, but the combination of the absolute massive amount of emotion behind and the authentic emotion behind it, and on top of that, being able to write that in your native language. So it was the probably the easiest process of writing a song that ever happened.
And the title is Sukupolvi and Unelma, translates as the dream of a generation or something, something along those along those lines. And it I think that in when you hear it in both languages, it's really apt because it's incredible. We started making the Finnish football show five and a half years ago, and episode 5 was titled "Is this the worst time to start a podcast about Finnish football?" Because things were bad. You know, we had the transition from Miksu to Hans Backer, and the football there was terrible. And now 5 short years later, we're talking about the first. Well, actually, it was 4 years later, wasn't it? Because this competition's delayed. But you know, 4 years later, we're talking about the first time that Finland has qualified for a major finals, and they really deserved it. The Nations League progress. You know, this wasn't a fluke. This was steady progress.
Yeah, it's quite an amazing journey, isn't it? It's great. Congrats for you guys for making it or keeping the podcast going for so many years. And it's quite amazing that you've been that there's been that growth, or you've seen the growth so closely with the podcast. It's quite a cool story.
Yeah, thank you. I think it's why we really connected with the song. You kind of made some of our team quite emotional. The first time I heard it was a few months ago, and I want to talk about this, how this song came about. But when I first heard it a few months ago, I was just like, oh, and I speak Finnish, but hearing lyrics and getting it straight away, I didn't get it quite straight away, but I felt it right away. And Keke said the same thing. He said that he had a tear in his eye. And you know, we're 40-something-year-old British men. So how do you feel about reducing 40-year-old British men to tears?
Oh man, it is the best kind of feedback you could possibly dream of. Because of course, for me, like I said, it was such a happy and an emotional thing. And you, as a songwriter, you really the goal is kind of to be able to translate that emotion to the music. So obviously, because it's funny, I've gotten messages from men and women, men saying, middle-aged men saying they listen to the song at their office during a work day and just burst into tears. And it's absolutely amazing. It's the best kind of feedback you can get, because then it tells you that the kind of, you know, if you're trying to succeed, that the feeling translates, and then that is quite a firm confirmation that it went good. So thank you for that.
No worries. And you, so Finnish men don't usually get emotional in the office, maybe in the sauna at the end of the day, but not in the office. So that's some success. There's one other connection actually between the lyrics and the Finnish football show. It says in the song, Viva la Revolution.
And
the word revolution was actually coined by Mark, one of the other hosts of the Finnish football show.
Oh really?
Yeah, he was the first one to say this, and there was a.
Oh really?
Yeah. Cool. Yeah, there was a book. I can't remember the name of the book now. That came out about a year or so ago about the progress of the Finnish national team, and Mark got his name in print as the first person to use the word revolution. So it was nice to hear. We were listening a week or so ago, and I was like, did he say revolution? We're in the song.
That's great. I didn't know that.
Tell me a little bit about Repliki as well. Am I right to think that he's an old friend of yours that's in the song doing the rapping section?
Absolutely. He's a good, great friend of mine, and Paulus as well from yeah, we moved to Nummela when I went to sixth grade, and I think with Reima Replikki, we met maybe a year after that, it was around that time that I started doing music, and we actually started with Replikki. We did our first songs in my bedroom with an old computer. I got this old, can't remember even the software that you use to make beats, and we started with Replikki. We both actually rapped. I rapped too, and then I sang the choruses, but quite soon it turns out that maybe I should stick to singing and Replikki we'll do the rapping. But we did songs for so many years together, and it was, when this same song came about, it was such an obvious choice to get Reima involved, and he did such a great service for the song, and he's such a talented, great guy. It's an honor to have him on the song too.
It's like your musical brother almost.
Yeah, absolutely. And we've over the years, musical brother is a good thing. Always exchanging ideas and working on songs together.
And so with Paulus, you've now started your own record label. Yeah. Is that so that you can have a bit more control over what you're doing, or what's the story?
Yes, we started with Paulus and our good friend Janne Kyöstilä, and because I have been with a major record label in Germany with Universal Music for years. I did my first album with them, and after the first album, I think I got a little, there was some kind of musical block. I don't know, like it took a few years that I only got released a few songs, and things were kind of going slowly, and we've kind of had this dream about our own label for a long time, but somehow it all now seemed like a really good timing for it, to kind of maybe like take a few steps back, go back to the back to the roots, and with just acoustic guitar and kind of do it ourselves. And it really was the best decision ever. Like the right away I could feel some pressure lift off my shoulders or something, but for creativity it was the absolute best choice, and it's been such an amazing journey so far with them too. That is really the dream to be able to work with your best mates.
And you're working on a new album. So you said about this creativity. So you've got a new album. Exactly. Will that be the first thing that comes to the new label, or do you have other plans for other artists as well?
So far, yeah. There's an EP coming this summer, EP with four songs, and then album later this year. And so far, of course, for the label, it would be amazing at some point to broaden it and involve more artists and stuff, but I think at this moment, as obviously Paulus is a little busy, I'm working on my own music, and Janne Kyöstilä, he's running a restaurant in Helsinki, Harju Kasi, which is doing really great, and so we're all busy on our own behalf. So at this moment it will be just my music, but absolutely in the future that would be great.
There's one thing about your relationship with Paulus that I wanted. I found a quote, and I found this quote in Finnish.
Yeah,
I'll read it in Finnish and then I'll translate it for the non-Finns that are listening. That Veljek said, Paulus ja Niila Arajuuri ovat kuin paita ja peppu. So brothers Paulus and Niila are like a shirt and a butt. It tickled me. Obviously, it's talking about you being close. I'd never heard that phrase before.
It's one of those Finnish phrases that doesn't make any sense when you translate it. But that's the meaning, that we have like Siamese twins since forever, or like since the beginning. We've always had same group of friends, played in same teams, and like Paulus moved away quite early. He moved, he was 16, he moved to Helsinki to go to Mäkelärin lukio, like for studying, and then obviously has moved abroad in different teams, but luckily for FaceTime and the technology these days, you can, you know, we call basically every day, and it never hasn't felt somehow with FaceTime, you know, you can, when you can see the other one and stuff, it doesn't feel the same. It would be different if we had to write letters for 20 years or something, you know. So, but we've been best friends always, and it's been such a blessing to have a brother so close and to share, like support each other in good times and bad times, and also with our little sister Adelina, we're all really close. So it's feel really blessed to have close siblings.
So this is probably a silly question then, but how much are you looking forward to these three games in the Euros, the first three games?
Oh man, my heart starts beating every time I even think about the first game. I don't know, man. I will definitely have to. I don't know. It will be emotional. It will be emotional, and but just. Yeah, I will be. I'm trying to think. Then I'm the one who's going to be on the home couch with a beer, and then I can only imagine what the players are going through. So I guess I will get. I should get through. But I think there will be, yeah, big emotions, tears, and excitement. It will be. Can't wait.
I'm excited. I know the other. Actually, Mark, the other Mark from the show is traveling. Still has plans to travel to some of the games. He was lucky enough to keep his tickets, and he's got, I think he's still got all of his tickets. So he's going to Copenhagen and to St. Petersburg. So we will be, we have a smaller squad traveling than we were planning to, but we've still got someone going out there. So that's awesome for him. But yeah, we're all just really, really pumped for this now, and it's only 8 days time that it all kicks off.
I know.
Niila, thank you so much for your time today. Please, when you speak to Paulus, pass on our kind of regards, our best wishes, good luck and everything to him and to the rest of the squad. And we'd love to have Paulus come on the show when he's a little less busy, you know, when he's not got a summer full of work to do. Yeah, but maybe after the competition, that would be awesome too.
Thank you so much for having me. It was so much fun, and it will be a great summer. Will be a great summer, and it's a great podcast you guys are doing. Keep it up. And thank you so much for having me. It was a lot of fun.
Yeah, thanks a lot. Maybe we'll play out now with a little bit of Sukupolvi and Unelma, and nice. play it to fade.
Yes. Thank you.
Alta sinisen taivaan peltojen päältä, läpi hangeen ei paikalle jäädä. Koivujen katvees keskellä metsää, paikka missä oma koti kirveellä tehdään. Täällä kansamme tarinoita täynnä, yhdellä lisää voi kansia täyttää. Aika huukaa ja siipänsä nostaa ja kertoa tarinaa, missä unelma on totta. Mä tunnen. Mä tunnen sen voimaan, tunnen sen voimaan. Kajat sille valkoinen vuori, kaunis on Suomi.